Hello and welcome to John Morey live and exclusive. Tonight's special guest, Michael Brody, ladies and gentlemen. Come here, Michael. Hello and welcome to John Murray, live and exclusive from Murray Machine Gymnasium in Stockport. And today, I'm very, very grateful to welcome our special guest, Michael Brody. How are you doing, Michael? Thanks
good,
for coming
mate,
on the show,
good.
Mate. Yeah. How's good. Life after boxing?
Not bad.
What's been happening? What have you been doing?
Bit shit. I'm on a building site, but, you know, I'm going to get back involved in the boxing.
Starting to do a bit.
Start training kids, yeah. Like you're doing.
Yeah, yeah. Building up the gym, mate. You know what it's like? This thing about boxing, right? When you're a boxer, you dedicate your whole life to being a boxer, right? Once you retire from boxing, you have to find your place in the world again. You are like a school leaver, like almost. You don't know where you belong, do you? So, what did you do when the day you retired? Do you know it was definitely over the day you retired?
I knew it was over because I went through a nasty divorce, and I just thought, you know what? I've had enough of it. Fell out of love with boxing because of Jack and everything.
Yeah.
Everything went on with him and I just thought, you know what, I can't be after this, just fell out of love with it, come away from it, but obviously it's all I know, I've done it from the age of 10, and of course. I thought, you know what, get back involved.
So what did you do after you finished with boxing, where did you go, what did you start doing, working
straight? Well, I'd done a bit of work and he hated that, then I'd done a bit of taxiing, as everyone knows, done a bit of jail after that, and then come back out, and now I'm on a building site, and it's not a bad, you know what I mean, it's not bad, it's wages, but I hate it. And my plan is get back involved in the boxing.
Well, back involved in boxing. Be around the sport. We dedicated our whole lives. This is what I say to people as well. Like, to be an high-level professional boxer, right, you can't half-ass it. You have to be all or nothing. So to be at the top of your game, you can't have no backup plans. I think you've got to be all into boxing. You've got to live your life of boxing.
Everything. You've got to live the life of boxing. Just diet, everything, running. You should run 6 days a week, 10 miles a day. Home, you just constantly like it. Your body's like a machine, you just constantly, you have something to eat, you're running it off, you're weighing yourself. It's hard work, innit? You know what I mean?
So, when you finish boxing there, then you've been a boxer for all these years, that's taken away, then, isn't it?
Of course,
because
it is.
You find your bit of freedom, you think, right, I can do what I want now. Usually, when you retire as well, it's after a big fight, you have one last big payday. And me, myself, when I retired, I didn't know it was going to be my last fight. But I had to fight for the colour money, and I thought, right, I had a feeling it was going to be my last fight, actually. So I set up the gym. I was clever with it. I thought, right, I need to do something with this money, so I set up the gym. I set up my business. But some people don't do that because they don't realise it's going to be the last fight. So did you know your last fight was going to be your last fight?
No, I just thought, well, yeah, they did and they didn't, because I thought, fuck it, I'll just go on a madden.
Yeah.
Went on holiday, had a top holiday, come back and then I thought, fucking hell, I've done all that doing.
Yeah, it goes quick.
And I thought, fuck me, what have I done?
It's like water in your hands, isn't it?
And then I thought, you know what am I doing now? It's hard work, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it is. Good boy.
And then everyone's, you're going to have to get a job. And I thought, what? Me? Famous kid and getting a job?
Yeah.
It's hard, you know what I mean?
Mate, I completely get where you're coming from with that. You know what it is? Because it's hard to work for someone to take orders, isn't it? We've always worked for ourselves.
Exactly.
Although saying that, though, we are told what to do and when to do it and what to eat and stuff like that. But we are our own bosses. It's us that gets in the ring and has a fight, innit?
Of course, yeah, of course it is, you know what I mean?
So, I do understand that, but
it is very hard, you know, like, when you're getting, right, you've got to do this, you've got to, I'm like, who the fuck are you talking to? I'll punch your head off. Don't talk to me like that.
Innit?
Fuming, you know what I mean? I'm thinking, can't be doing this, but then after the beat, you just got to bite your lip and just get on with it, you know what I mean? Just carry on doing what you got to do.
Yeah, that's right, you've got to make your way through in it, yeah. So, what are you thinking about, like, next with this gym? How are we going to
get going? Now, I'm trying to get, because I'm from Colliers, right near the city centre. It's a rough area. There's nothing at all for the kids. Nothing at all. They built all Ancos up now, and now they're doing it on Colliers, bringing all that up. So as soon as that comes up, my plan is get a boxing gym round there and get all the kids. Because I know all the little rough kids round there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And they all look up to me, I know. So my plan is get another champion from Colliers, like I've done. And like Brian Kidd and all that from there, you know what I mean? So I just want to put back into the community where I'm from what I've done.
Yeah, of course.
In my life, you know what I mean?
But you've got all that experience on the side, so why not share it? Do you know what I think as well, right? They talk about this a lot, but I think they should bring boxing back into schools. Do you know why? Because
100% you should do that.
Every single kid, I think, should be made to at least have one amateur fight.
Of course.
It sorts out all the shit. Do you know what I mean?
Well, they make
you've got a lot of kids with big mouths.
Of course he does. That and all them. Plus, like, you get some kids that are lazy. You get some kids that are backward and daft.
Yeah.
But you put them on the right track and it sorts it out.
It gives them all the right,
gives
right
them all
place,
the right
yeah.
contribution, you know what I mean?
Nice one.
Cheers, Aka.
Yeah.
Warm up now.
Aka, do us a favour, mate. Go knock on that door for us and just give it a nice one, mate. Yeah, so... Wait, right, so what I'm here for today, mate, what I want to know for you is, right, because this is the thing about boxing, what I think is, it's like the secret side of boxing, what no one knows about. It's talking about the great, great secrets, like, it's kept all hush hush what every fighter's making and stuff like that. No one's allowed to know. And I think the reason why no one's allowed to know is because the promoters don't want no one to know. So if I know you're getting paid X amount for a fight, and then I'm fighting for the same title as you, I want the same as you, you're getting, but he can undercut me if I don't know what you're getting. So, what do you think needs to be done about this state of affairs with boxing? Because I don't think boxers are getting paid right.
Well, they're not. I don't know, because I've been with all the promoters. I was with Frank Moran first. Frank Maloney was good.
Yeah.
He was good, but I had hard fights. I had wars, you know what I mean?
I remember them, yeah.
Big wars, you know what I mean? And then I won that European title, defended that 7 times. It was hard.
Seven times. That's some going night, innit?
You know what I mean? It was good. You know, like, and then I never look back and I think, good fights him, you know what I mean? But it was all Eastern European kids and they were good kids, come from nothing, you know. Yeah. Same as me, come from nothing.
Tough kids.
Tough, hard fights.
Yeah.
And I got paid well, whereas now look, I'm hearing what some of the fighters are getting today. Shocking, you know
it
what I mean?
It is shocking. It leaves a bit of taste in
your mouth,
yeah. Doesn't it?
Of course, it does.
It does. But why is this happening then? So, like, I think a lot of boxers, right, it's the same old story, innit? 6 months after they retire, you see a lot of boxers, they're fucking superstars. I know a lot of Manchester fighters who I look like, too, like gods. And I look at him now and I think, fuck, it's not right how he is. Mm. I think how's he ended up down there, like the way he is? Because there's not, I don't think there's any help for fighters after the retire.
With the footballers, they get help.
Yeah,
they get money punched into them and everything. With those boxers, you just get left. The managers leave you, they're not interested in you. Yeah. My manager, I looked up to him like he was my dad.
Yeah.
I love that. I'm the only fighter who lived at his house for 8 weeks of the fight, you know what I mean? And then when he's going through divorce and everything, yeah, I'll be there, I promise you I'll be there. I'll come quote with you all this. I was going through an hard fight with Scott Addison and I did want to fight and I didn't, because the money was good and I thought, take it. He said, you never get this money again, so I thought, right, I'll take it. Took the fight, come with me, head in the fight room. Am I going to get paid this, am I going to get paid that?
Yeah.
So I just thought, you know what, take the easy way out. So the body shot and then I didn't hear from Jack, didn't see an out of him. You know what I mean? And he's the one making the big dough for me.
Yeah.
And someone who you think's dead close with you, all of a sudden just shut you down and just leave it. And like, I'm left in the cold now. I'm on my own, doing my own thing.
Well, this is the thing, isn't it? Because fighters are taken from teenage boys, I think. You're a boy, aren't you, when you turn pro? I was 18.
Of course. 21 when I turned pro.
21, so you're young. You're still a boy, aren't you? You've got these people around you. Your manager, your promoter, your trainer. They're all like father figures in a way.
Yeah, of course.
Do you know what I mean? Like me and Joe Gallagher was exactly the same. I was with Joe from being 14. And he was like a father figure. I'd do everything with him. I'd be with him for all my runs. I'd be in the gym with him every day. We speak on the phone constantly. But you are right. Once you're used up or once you're retired.
Once you're retired and you're not earning them money, it's goodbye.
It's goodbye.
See you later. We'll get the next one in.
It is. And it's a big part of growing up for the fighter.
Of course it is.
How old are you
wrong.
Retired, mate?
I retired when I was 30, I think it was 35, 36, and then I made the comeback when I was 38.
Yeah.
And I boxed, they got me an hard fight, my first fight, Simon Ricky Hatton, because he thought he was my pal.
Yeah.
Signed with him, he got me an hard fight. Kid put me down and split me high in the first two rounds.
Yeah.
And then I come back and knocked him out in the fourth. So I said to him, Ricky, after the fight, I said, Ricky, I'm not being funny, you know me, I'll fight anybody, yeah. But, you know, just get me a few warm-up fights, get me a few easy fights to get back into it. And then I come back in the gym, have a week out of the gym, go back in the gym, and it's, oh, Mike, you can't do that. You got to fight Crawler. I went, what?
Fucking
Crawler. I've had one fight on the comeback fight, and then you put him with Crawler, he's top of the game.
Yeah.
In rank number one in Britain, yeah. Fighting British champion, you know what I mean? And I'm not knocking Ricky, I'm not knocking Crawler, but me and my day, yeah. No, he wouldn't have got in the ring with me. Yeah. Not a prayer, and I know it.
Yeah, I agree with you.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. But it's just, that's the way boxing is, though. Because you realise you're a piece of meat, the fighters are a piece of meat, aren't they?
You're just
a commodity for the business.
Of course it is. It's like, say, first comeback fight. Boxers had a velodrome. I sold the velodrome out. 3,000 people. You don't see that now.
Yeah.
You can't. You know, you don't see these up and coming kids going and selling shows out straight away. Yeah. You don't see it.
I did that for the Crawler fight.
That's what I'm saying. You know what I mean?
Here's one fair. I sold for the Crawler fight. I've been out of the ring for 2 years. I had one comeback fight against John Simpson. I won in 2 rounds, and then I jumped straight to the Crawler fight. And I fancied the Crawler fight because I sparred with Crawler for years. Yeah, I knew Crawler. I was too much of an handful for him, I thought, at the time. So I've jumped into the fight. Obviously, I've got beat, but for the Crawler fight, I sold 50 grand worth of tickets for the Amir Arena. And so I got paid for it, 35 grand. So I give Eddie Earn 15 grand to box Andy Crawler.
Shocking.
It's mad, isn't it? That's how bad the game is.
But how much did Crawler get?
I don't know.
This is what I'm saying.
I don't know.
And it's like with me, I got 10 grand for that fight. He would have got double that, probably.
Do you think so? Because this is what I'm saying. Because at the time when you boxed Crawler, use the A side, use a bigger name.
I was the bigger name, but I was at the end of my career.
He was at the end of the career. I think when I boxed Crawler, I was a bigger name. Stepping stone.
Yeah. That's it. You just, you're stepping stone.
Stepping stone.
And like, then when you beat, you forgot about no one wants to know.
No.
It's like, I had fans from America and everywhere writing to me, and all of a sudden, you just stopped and I think, what's going on?
It's shockingly bad.
It's horrible at night. When you're famous, because you're famous, you used to have been coming, I am Mike, and now I'm just a normal kid like everyone else, you know what I mean? And I think, fucking, that's how it is.
It's tough coming to terms with that, isn't it?
It's really hard.
It's hard coming to terms with it.
At a minute now, I'm on a building site, I hate it. But it's a wage every week, and I've got to do something.
Yeah.
Because if I don't do something,
I retired,
I think. I'm down and depressed.
I mean, 5 years ago, 31. Well, 6 years ago, right, I retired. And I'm not going to lie, it was hard for me. I had to rediscover my place in the world again, find out where I belonged. Get used to being a normal person is hard, isn't it? Because you're told to get up and run.
And you used to, like, all your mates. I had loads of mates.
Now I can non-stop
on the phone, Brody coming out now. I've got about 4 mates that we can relate with my proper pals. Yeah. Who are classing my proper pals.
Yeah.
I can go to them anytime and say, all right, mate, you're up to? And they say, what you up to? Come in and have a brew and chill with them. Whereas years ago, we had loads full of them. And I'm going out spending loads of money and thinking, I'm pissed after 2 pints. I ain't spent that. I'm going out taking guns out and thinking, going home with not a cannon in my pocket, thinking, fucking, I ain't spend that.
I used to do the exact same thing.
And then I got on it. At the end, I just thought, you know what? In a bit with it, but it's like, say, it's boxing. It's the life. And
it's boxing, because you are a boxing man, right? So what it is about that is, you have got this a charisma, a certain attachment. People come to you, they navigate towards you, especially like men and that. Yeah. Because they want to be a part of that fucking...
Because they want to be a part of you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, they want a piece
of... I've trained with him, you know what I mean? And I'm buzzing, I'm training. I think that's where I'm training with the champ.
But these people are very fickle because it does after... It's literally the day I lost... The last fight of my career, the day I lost fight, it was just like instant switch off. The phone just dropped dead.
That's how it is, John.
That's it.
I had a big house in Salford. I used to throw parties and all that there. And then in the end, I just buried it because it was all bumping taxes from me.
From my house,
I got blacklisted and I went asked because I was driving, you know what I mean? I went asked, I don't use taxes anyway. Yeah. But then when you need a tax, you tell your kids, it's horrible, you know what I mean? Thinking, what's going on? And these are supposed to be your mates who love you, then, you know what I mean? And idolise you and all that, but they want It's like no, saying
they're all about for the piece of the pie.
That's what it is with everyone. I've come to terms with it. Everyone's after the piece of the pie, and when you're doing good, everyone wants to know you. When you're down here, no one wants to know you.
But that's life, though, isn't it?
It's life, isn't it?
That's just life in general, yeah. It's a tough lesson, isn't it, being a boxer. Can we come around the side? What's your advice for young fighters coming through? If you could do it all again, how would you do it differently?
If we could do it all again, I would have listened to my manager, and I wouldn't have.
Yeah.
And another thing, I wouldn't have got married.
No.
No. Never.
No.
Never.
Women, don't get me started on women.
And another thing, I just think, just stack it away and
look after
and
it.
Build your little pie.
Do you know what I do? Sometimes I think about this myself, but do you know what I think to myself? You only have one youth. I had a cracking youth, I'm sure you did.
I had a wild youth.
Wild, top. I won't change any of that. I probably could have done things a little bit different, but I had a top youth, and I don't regret it.
I had a good, you know what? I don't regret my life, and I don't regret the boxing, what I've done, and I don't regret what I've done, you know what I mean, in my life. I've been, you know, how many people can say they flew over to America with Barry Earn and lived a dream, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Went over there with Jamie Moore. Jamie Moore had just had a fight. I partied for 3 weeks. Seeing a bit, I said, Jamie, what are you doing now? Nah, man, I'm back, I'm seeing a bit, now I'm partying. I just went partying.
Yeah, seeing that's a bit, sick.
You know what I mean? On a break, you know, you train all your life.
Yeah.
And you train and fight, and then, you know, you want a blowout.
You do need a blowout.
It's hard.
Do you know what I went to fights, me, where I live like a monk. like a monk, and some of the performances were crap.
Mm.
I think because I wasn't happy. Whereas I went into other fights when I'd been on a piss 2 or 3 weeks before a fight. And I'd go to the gym the next day and I'd be training with the lads and I'd be buzzing and I'd tell them a story about something that happened the night before. But I'd get a buzz off it and it made me train harder. And then I'd go into the fight with an happier state of mind. And I found that my performances were better.
Yeah.
Until later on in my career, it all catches up with you.
I just had wars, and I just thought, you need to start learning and box proper and in and out. And my trainer Ray had me doing that. It's like, say, I've not seen Ray for ages, and I've seen him, when was it, about, I think it was last year. And he says to me, I'll have to catch up, you know. I took his number. I says, yeah, I'll catch up. I'll have to catch up for the drink. I don't drink, I'll give it up.
Oh, that's good.
Because I can't be my way. I'm pissed after 2 pints.
Yeah.
And I'm the worst nightmare, you know what I mean? I have an hangover for like 3 days, so I don't see the point in drinking.
Yeah.
No point.
Yeah, it's not the same.
Going out spending loads of money, and I think, it's not me, fuck that.
Nah, I'm done with it. Yeah, I've slowed down as well. I stopped the day before my birthday this year. So this year, this is my 37th year, nice and sober.
It's good.
Doing well.
You know what I mean? It's hard, but it's like I say, I don't really go out. I don't go out no more. I'm not in the party scene. I've done it over because I'm 47, I'm not a kid no more, my man. I've got kids.
Yeah.
Don't want them seeing me being daft, you know what I mean? So I don't go out no more, just staying.
I think everyone gets there though, don't they?
Yeah, in the end.
We all find our way.
You get bored of it, you know what I mean?
You get bored, yeah.
Doing the same thing every weekend.
It's the same shit, it's boring, same people, you know what I mean? same house party, same kitchen.
Exactly.
Same conversation, exactly. Time again, boring, man, yeah. I get it. Sounds. What's been, what are you thinking about? Are you doing any training?
So my plan is, you know what, John, I'll be dead straight. I'm not training for mums, but I've just got one of them juices, started juicing, doing that for a bit, and hopefully I'll leave my belly will go, and then I'll get back into training.
I've
I know I'm fit anyway, because I can go out and go and start, I can go and do 10 miles now, you know, running, because I don't smoke, I don't drink.
That's the same.
I'm still fit, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
and it's in my head. Get out and do it.
Better
into
when I do the bath, I'll get 40 on my jumps every time.
Yeah.
It's better into me.
Yeah.
I'll do 10 bar bag now and I'm not training for ages, you know what I mean? Just whack it out. I started training again 2 or 3 weeks ago. Feel mint for it though, because I never used to understand them people that said, oh, training gives you more energy and that, because we used to train ourselves till we was exhausted on the floor.
Yeah, till you're dying, you know what I mean?
And then we go home, we eat, we sleep, we get up, we train. And like, I used to hate training, thought, fucking hell, it's hard, dude. You're punishing yourself. But now I'm doing a little bit of training, I feel mint.
Yeah, it releases all the...
Yeah,
like, feel obviously, mint. I'm not going to lie, I suffered with depression for a bit. I was depressed and dead down because of where I've been up here.
Yeah.
And then I've come rock bottom and I thought, wow, how do you dig yourself out, you know what I mean?
Correct, yeah.
My head was burnt out and all that. And And my sister's listening to start taking. I'm having no tablets.
This is.
I'm not having none of that. I don't do it even though. I just started running and that released all, you know what I mean?
Makes you feel better.
I believe if you train yourself, like we've trained ourselves all our lives, it gets rid of all these.
Yeah, you are correct. Bit of training, bit of fresh air.
Yeah.
Well, even a walk with a dog. Yesterday I was a bit wound up the other day. I took my dog out for a walk, right? And you know what? I felt mint after.
Yeah.
Felt happy again. Just a bit of fresh air and a bit of exercise sorts you out.
I had a belting dog, but my ex-partner put him in the garden. He went missing. Never seen it again. So I never got another dog. I won't have a dog now.
No.
It's hard work, you know what I mean?
I won't have a dog after him.
You've got, it's like a kid, isn't it? You've got to take it out 3 times a day. You've got to feed it.
Yeah.
it's not the dog's fault. It's hard work, you know what I mean?
It's hard work, yeah.
Mine used to run with me to like 6 days a week, my staff. He was a belt, I used to run everywhere with me.
I got him for running. Yeah. I used to go running and that when I was training and I took him for running, but since I retired, he's got fat and so have I. I've got fat and so
have I. But as in, it's like, say, we should be now training the next club and coming kids.
So what do you think about this then, right? So in boxing, these, I think the trainers and the people that are involved in it tend to be the ones at the top, tend to have no boxing background. Do you understand?
Yeah, I understand.
You see people
who are training kids and I think, how can you train kids when you've never been in the ring? Never had a fight?
I think this is important because I went to my world title fight with Joe Gallagher in my corner, right? And I watched the fight back me after, but I remember what Joe was saying to me in the ring. Do you know what I mean? Like, how much do you want it and that? Come on, John, keep going. And I thought, obviously I fucking want it because look at the fucking state of my face. I'm trying. Do you know what I mean? But what you should have been telling me is, John, you're getting caught in the right uppercut there. Why don't you block it?
Block it and move, you know what I mean?
I mean, I think this is things that fighters can see what people that haven't been in the ring can't see or not aware of. So I can watch a spar sometimes and I watch it for 10 seconds and I can already see something there what that kid who I'm training needs to do. Yeah, I think if you're a fighter, that's built into you because...
Of course, because you need to know
when
what...
that bell goes, no one's controlling you.
Can you? You're
the only one. And he's like, you have to look and assess the person you're fighting, don't you?
Yeah, of course. And it's like you say, when it gets hard in there, and you're having it hard, and seriously, I'm not going to lie, I had loads of wars. Everyone knows I had wars. Most of my fights are wars.
Yeah.
The Neil Swain one, I pissed blood for 3 days after
that.
No one sees all this, you know what I mean?
No, don't see it.
You don't see it all, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you're correct.
He broke my nose in the first round. And I was like, I'm not going to lie, I was getting beaten that fight and I knocked him out in the 10th because I listened to my trainer.
Yeah. Oh, they can make a big difference in the fight, can't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, you definitely are right. But I just think if you're a boxer, an ex-boxer, I think there's something more to give to the game. There's too many ex-boxers for my liking. Once they retire, just fucked off. Or they're not involved in boxing no more. I don't know why that is. I think when boxing finishes, right, I think a lot of boxers leave the sport with a sour taste in the mouth. They hate boxing because I hated boxing.
I'm not gonna lie, that's how it turned me. Yeah. I feel like I love with boxing.
I felt
because everyone who knows my manager and everyone knows all the up and coming kids, you know what I mean, and all the proper managers and all that. Everyone knows them all. They're all snidey, you know what I mean?
Proper snidey.
How much that word? And like, you can't when you go into like when you come away from it and you try and go back into it and you're still the same people there and thinking, I don't want to bother with them. You know what I mean? You knocked me sick and I thought, I don't want to bother with them. I can't be mired with it. So I'll come away from it.
Yeah.
But now, obviously, it's all I know when I'm working on a building site. Don't get me wrong, it's a wage every week and it's good, but I shouldn't be doing that.
I've struggled with the same point myself. I'm quite a high level operator like yourself. But then I'm working in the gym sometimes. I'm working with kids. And don't get me wrong, I love working with kids, mate. I enjoy the training and I don't mind it.
Yeah, it's good because you're putting them through everything we've done in our lives,
I'm teaching what I know, but then I think at the same time, I think, why aren't I training pro fighters? I should be training pro boxers.
Really. Exactly, you know what I mean? You should be making a working with it.
A five-year-old kid, which I love doing anyway. But I mean, I think sometimes I think, well, I could go to a pro gym. And I go into the pro gym sometimes, I listen to the trainer, and I think, he's not on it. I listen to him, but what there is a lot of in boxing is them people who just like sneak around the scenes whispering in people's ears and that. I don't know how to do it. I wish I knew. I don't know how to do it.
And they get away with it.
They do get away with it, yeah.
They get away with it and people think, oh, he's a top trainer.
Hang around fucking.
I'll do this, I'll do that.
That's what I'm saying. So it's not so much as you being top trainers. It's more that you've got top fighters, isn't it?
Mm. Well, I believe if you've got a good fight, you only need one or two good fighters.
You want a good
two. And then your gym gets full.
It does.
Because I used to train at Mossad Champs Camp. It was only me, Ensley Bingham. Yeah. Got stubborn then.
Yeah.
Me, Ensley Bingham, Carl Thompson, and then everyone else followed.
Comes, doesn't it?
Peter Judson was there with us.
You was there with us.
There was loads, and then the gym was always rammed and hammered. Now, the gym's empty down my side.
Is it?
Who'd you got there?
Yeah,
my mate phoned me the other day, myself, says, come on.
Yeah.
Come and sort, bro, you need to sort the gym out. It's not my gym, mate.
Yeah, I can't do now.
Yeah. It's not my gym, I'm not.
Is Morris still down there?
Morris is still there, and I spoke to Morris, and he's saying he's got an ABA champion and all that, but
yeah,
the gym's shut in the day and it was open all day. That's what I've heard. Do you know what I mean?
It's weird.
Open all day, and you know when we used to go there, yeah, it's good crap.
It's good, yeah.
Going there, start at 12 o'clock, come out there at 3 o'clock.
Yeah, sweat.
The gym is hammered, do you know what I mean?
Sweat box and a tune.
You drive past there, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Now you drive past there, it's dead.
I don't know if it's times we're living in, though, you know.
It probably might be.
The times are just going, I think, I don't know, might just be getting a bit older, a bit bitter, but for me, it just seems these times we're living are not as good as it was 10 years ago. Is that just me?
No, I believe it is, you know. I believe it's like that.
It's just getting slower times have changed. Times are changing.
It's like, you get some fighters, because I'm always watching the boxing, because I love it, it's bred in me, you know what I mean? I watch the fights all the time.
I tell you what,
and I watch anything, what's going on?
I tell you what, I remember first time bum Shannon's gym. You know, across the house.
Bob Shannon's gym,
it's
yeah.
A picture of you on a little A4 piece of paper thrown.
With my little afro. With my little perm.
That's the one.
I remember that, with my little perm.
I remember that. How mad's that? Throwing a little jab. So
like saying, no, you don't. I've not heard about Bob for years.
No.
Don't even know where he is, don't even know if he's training anymore.
Don't know what happened to him. No, I've not seen for himself for a bit. I've spoke to his his nephew or something. He's on my Facebook.
Yeah.
Promotes him a little bit. I don't know where Bob's gone though. I'm not sure what's happened to him. But it's just mad, isn't it? In life, mad how it works out in the end.
It's mad, proper mad. But my plan is, that's my plan, just sort somehow in college and get another champion from college like I've done.
Yeah.
You know, I've come from there.
You've got too much to give.
That's what I'm saying.
And, in the sport.
And I just want to get back involved in boxing because it's
what
all,
about
you know?
Manager's license?
I don't want to go into managing. It's hard graft, isn't it?
Is it?
I think it's hard graft.
I've got my manager's license.
No, Jack used to go through a lot. And I look at Gary Beav, he's doing all right.
Do you know what I think nice is? I won't say it was so much Alan Graft. It's just, us boxers as people, we're lazy people. We'd have to sit down and do it. Do you know what I mean? We just want to go bum one phone call done. I think there's a bit more to it than that.
More than that to it. You've got to sort stuff out. Like I say, when I used to do my deals with Jack, Jack would be on the phone and then say, right, he's here, right, he's sat right beside me. Yeah, Mike, have a word with him.
Yeah.
And that's how I got on with Frank Malone, eh? And then I went from Frank Malone back to Barry Hearn. Started with Barry Hearn.
Barry Hearn's a good man, though, isn't he?
He's a top man.
Yeah, I remember Barry. He's a good man.
Yeah. I think Frank Malone was a top man.
Yeah.
You know, I done good with him, and I can't knock him.
I think I boxed on the really good.
Few fights and every one of them are top the bill and sold out for done brilliant.
Did you box in America?
No. That was my downfall. States? I reckon if it would have boxed in America, it would have been massive.
Yeah, massive. Yeah.
Massive.
It's massive. Because you know what I think seems to happen is money seems to be better just before I turned pro. Your era was a little bit better. It seems to have gone on a low when I boxed and then it's gone back up again.
But I think when I was fighting though, like everyone says America's brilliant. I didn't have to go there because I was getting massive dough in England.
Yeah, he was doing well over there.
I was doing really good. Yeah. And I was fighting all over England, London, Scotland. I was fighting everywhere.
Yeah, and packing it out as well.
Packing out Newcastle. I was fighting everywhere, you know what I mean?
There's no feeling like that though, is there?
There's no better feeling where it's like, now you look at some of the kids and I think, I feel sorry for them.
Yeah.
Because they try to make the name that we've made, you know what I mean? What we've done with our
What's
life.
The...
I was coming up through the careers and I'm thinking, it's harder now for them.
Hard to make a name.
I reckon it is, yeah.
You think?
I think it is, yeah.
I think it's easier because of the social medias and that. Everyone, like, all you have to do is get on social media, start acting a clown. I don't like boxing, me. I don't like the way it's being portrayed out. Like, I think that these fighters now, it's becoming like WWF wrestling. And they're acting idiots, clowns.
Like the YouTubers.
Yeah, they're acting like clowns.
Earning fortunes. Good luck to him though, you know what I mean? He's done really good and take me after the kid, but...
Who's that?
That Jake Paul and that, his brother. Just clowns to me. Life.
But they are making some dumb...
Wow, the money they're earning.
Yeah, well, John,
it's crazy, you know what I mean? But that's what I'm saying, good luck to him.
Do you think it has to be more like wrestling? Do you think boxers have to start being more like clowns? Because for me, I watch it sometimes and I can tell that's a stage thing. They've asked me to do it in the past. So John, when you get up on stage, push him or something. I'm like, fuck that, no, I'm not doing nothing like that. Do you know what I mean?
I think some of it's like that.
Some
right,
of it's stage,
to
isn't it?
Build, yeah, to build the fight
to
up,
to build
it.
Up, innit? But would you do anything like that?
No.
No, I wouldn't.
Not if he want me.
He want me. Because when I'm there for the fight, I'm there for the fight. I'm just concentrating on fighting.
That's it. And just getting... My thing was, I just concentrating on getting in there and getting them out there as quick as
that's it, yeah. It's business, isn't
it? Get it over with.
I didn't think nothing personal. I just looked at him and thought, you're in the way. If I win this fight, I carry on getting paid. If I lose this fight, I'm fucked. And that is the pressure what's on boxers.
Yeah, that's what it, of course it is.
That's the pressure what's on.
It's on everyone, isn't it? You know, even if a young fighter today would do... Doing good out of it.
It's not like a football team, is it?
It's not like football.
You lose a match. Your team loses a match.
You still get paid.
You're not fucked, are you? That's maybe why they're a bit more fucking laid back about it, running around. We're fighting like our lives are on the line because.
But is your life on the line, isn't it? You know what I mean? Because you're getting punched everywhere.
You're getting punched in the head,
I got out of some fights, my eyes shut, closed like that.
Yeah. I've seen pictures.
Little wobble head. Oh, my mate's just scared, your little wobble head, and I'm like,
I've cracked my skull. I'm blind in one eye.
Yeah.
I've been pissing blood after fights and all that. Same as yourself.
It's not good that when you're pissing blood, mate. Pissing blood.
Like clumpy pee.
Yeah, mate, what's going on?
What's that? But it is what it is. What do you used to do after your fights? Do you used to go straight out or?
Fucking going, I'm adding. I'm just trained for trained for 9 weeks like a cunt.
That's it, yeah.
And I go right out and get on the beer.
Yeah.
And well, take it in mind, I'm pissed after 2 pints.
Yeah.
And I used to have about fucking 100 of them out with me. So it'd be mayhem in town, you know what I mean?
Oh, it'd be good.
Night, it's a brilliant night, you know what I mean? It was good and David's good memories.
They're top memories, aren't they? I remember some of my after parties, like we just finished and that was it, bang. I was beamed straight on the beer. I got missing for a couple of days.
That's it, you know, because you've not drank for years. And
yeah, you've worked hard, haven't you?
Just got to have a proper blowout, you know. I think you need that blowout.
You need the blowout. I think it's good for you. And I think I'm not saying every fight is different, but for me, it worked for me, it worked for you. Mm. I needed that blowout because I had that fucking pressure built on you. And once you've won that fight, that pressure's off. That's why everyone celebrates.
Yeah, of course it is.
Because you think, fucking, whoa, good. It's not just about the pressure of winning the fight, it's the pressure of everyone you know bought tickets for to watch that fight. So you think,
of course. And you're right, and you're thinking, they're all getting that ring getting knocked out.
That's exactly what you're thinking. I think the same. They're all getting knocked out in front of everyone, you know, deal.
I still get it now. Come here, mate. Sure, you got battered off in your diva, and I'm like, what? Fucking carry on, you get a crack, and they just laugh at me.
Yeah. It's mad, isn't it? I shared your fight with Minjin Chi the other day.
I seen it. That was a war, that fight.
That was some fucking
I wonder what he's doing now, though, you know what I mean? Because I bet he's set, where he's living now, I bet he's set for life, you know what I mean? He's living his soul career.
What happened?
Nothing there, and there's big money over there, you know what I mean?
So what do you think we need? What do we need? I think there needs to be something put in place for fighters, because...
There should be something put in place for fighters, like the footballers have, when you finish, you get looked after with them, and they show you how to sort your money out, and invest your money into different things.
So
you're getting on and that with us.
So when I was fighting, I get paid, and it was like, right, I had to pay my manager, pay my trainer, pay my promoter, whatever. I'm left with this pot of money, right? And then I had no one giving me any sort of guidance. I'm just a fucking 21-year-old kid. I've got fucking 100 mates. I've got a big family. And I'm thinking I've got a big pot of money here now. And everyone knows I've been paid. Everyone's excited. You just won your fight by knockout. They're all running over to you. And you all just think, fuck it. You're a kid, aren't you?
You don't know what
you're
like.
You don't know what you're doing, do you?
You think
it's never ever going to end.
That's what you think. It's never ever going to end.
It's never going to end. Because what you do is, when my money started getting low, I think, right, I better get back to the gym now. Go and have another fight, have a top up. Bam, bam, bang. Start living the high life again. Money getting low, I think, right, fuck it, back to the gym.
Yeah, that's how it goes.
It's good, isn't it? But time takes its toll on anyone, and wear and tear gets ahead of you, don't it? So I started feeling it towards the back end of my career.
I wanted to get back involved in the boxing and get these good kids, because there's loads of good kids from these rough backgrounds, you know what I mean, what need advising and putting proper, so putting straight, because you get a load of kids now, they're just wild.
Wild.
And it's not like our generation. They're either on the game, sat on the game, or if they're not on the game, they're out robbing people.
Yeah.
Dragging birds out of cars. It's no good.
No, it's getting wild out as well. Yeah.
Wild.
Bad. We need... boxing is nothing better than boxing, though, is there?
He should be placed in schools, I think.
Should be placed in schools, yeah.
Like football, he should be placed in schools, because I think he does a lot for the kids, you know, when he's boxing.
He does a lot of help for
the kids.
He did a lot for me. He brought me... he added confidence to myself, and it does massive, massive amounts for you, doesn't it?
Of course he does.
But
he does a lot.
I think it sorts you out as well, because you know what it's like to get punched in the face, and you know how to give a crap.
Of course you do. So no one will bully you. When you're fighting, no one will bully you.
It just stops, doesn't it? You know where you're up to in the world.
You know where you're going. And you're I think scared. It's good.
Yeah, it's a top little discipline. I mean, sometimes it gets a bad rap, doesn't it? Saying we're fucking this, that, and the other. But you I don't know no fighters out of balloons. I think everyone that's a fighter has all got they're pretty controlled. And they seem to, most fighters I know seem to avoid conversation if possible. Oh, do you know what I was talking about the other day, Stephen? I don't even remember this. Me and you was out in town, and Steve said, oh, ask Brody about that fight we had. I was like, hey, Zim, do you remember that?
Yeah, I do remember it. And your mad brother, he's crazy. Funny, big. He's massive.
He's big, deaf.
Went out with him. Oh, we had murders. It was fucking funny. Top night. Top fight, you know what I mean? Top fight, not to get out. Fucking mega.
So you know what, these are the people.
But obviously when you're growing up as a teenager and you're coming from the city right near the city, you're out all the time. I was always fighting.
Yeah.
And it comes like, you get to know all the doormen. There's that little cunt again, don't let him in. Yeah. Yes, all the doormen. Got bad from that club, and all from your kid. Bad from it for life.
What was it?
I think he was he's still there now.
AXM?
No, not AXM. Not the press club. The one where Sasha's way to go downstairs.
Oh, yeah.
Bad from it. For life. mega night. He's a top night.
Yeah.
I remember you, brother. He's fucking crazy cunt.
Yeah, he's a mad cunt. He's
funny though. Top, proper
top
funner.
Lad. Top lad. One bum evil. I've seen Steven chin more people than anyone.
He's got a right
kick. Bang, out cold on the back. I said, you better get out of town. Fucking hell. But, do you know why that was? Because he was always very, very protective of me. Like, I'm happy go lucky me. I'm pretty laid back and that. And sometimes kids might give me a bit of fucking hell, but I know, I can see it coming and I swerve it. But if he sees it, he goes, fuck that, bang. Oh, he's got no fucking patience for it. But
trying is the way.
Good for him. I've been saying for him, to be fair.
Yeah.
I'm different with myself. Do you know what I mean? What have you got planned for later on today? Everything out done?
Just going to go home now, after there, chill with my kids, and get something to eat, and just watch a bit of telling and fucking back to work tomorrow.
Cool, dude, then, mate. Nice one, Mike.
Nice.
Thanks for coming down, mate. I appreciate that, mate. Top man. Top man. Top man, mate.